The ice pick or engineer's scriber. It's one of those tools you think you can make do without, but once you get one, it's truly indispensable for all tasks at hand. I spent the last 6 years compiling my best and most random tricks utilizing it. Starting with sawing. When ripping boards and cutting plastics, having the blade bind is a common occurrence due to internal stress or melting. I find the simplest way to mitigate this is by wedging an ice pick into the kerf, which reduces the friction significantly. If your saw doesn't have a blade stop, as was the case with my drill-powered circular saw, replacing the blade can be a challenge, but not anymore. I use an ice pick to quickly deburr parts on projects where it's not critical, but where I still want to avoid getting cut by a sharp burr. You can use a hook pick to help you drill straight. As soon as you drift away from 90 degrees, it'll slide on the shank. This is especially useful in situations where visibility is poor. If you don't have a syringe on hand, an ice pick may do the job just as well if you're careful. If you work with metal, your phone speaker is prone to attracting a lot of fine metal dust. I stick a strong magnet to my ice pick to magnetize it to extract the dust after metalworking. When a nut doesn't fit any bolt and I can't determine by eye if it may be a left-hand thread, I simply use an engineer's scriber. I found this especially useful for finer threads. The engineer's scriber is the perfect tool for removing wood filler from screw heads for using lumber. I use them constantly to manipulate hardware into places I struggle to reach. For instance, here I'm unable to fit a wrench inside, so I'm pulling on the nut with the bent side of the scriber, and here I'm wedging it to hold the nut in place to tighten a bolt. Here I'm using it to hold parts while making this hinge. I do this often when bolting parts with tight tolerances. I insert the ice pick first to align the parts, then insert the bolt, utilizing the ice pick to guide it in. Hard drives typically have a hidden screw or two to dissuade disassembly. I use an ice pick to locate them. I take these apart for their strong neodymium magnets. Many electronic devices also have rubber feet or pads that conceal the screws holding them together. If you're a true professional, you use your ice pick while making an ice pick. To remove metal shavings, clean magnets without touching them, open a clogged glue bottle, and place magnets precisely, all in one move. But if you're not a pro, this happens. Here I'm using the ice pick to release a silicone cast from its mold. I make these to use them later for mixing two-part epoxy. I love scavenging ATX power supplies for their heavy-duty switches. However, pushing them out of the enclosure is quite difficult due to the springy tabs that keep them in place. An ice pick is great for poking these tabs to bend them back, as well as expanding them later in their new enclosure. The ice pick is useful for electronics work as well. I use it to hold components in place while soldering, to flick away components while desoldering, to apply flux precisely on small parts, and to hold alligator clips open for removing and reinserting the sleeve for soldering. A tapered ice pick makes it extra useful for alligator clips of all sizes. Stepping on a bullet connector is all too common for me, but I've managed to repair these quickly in an emergency. Typical screw connectors have a flap that protects wires, but can impede connecting thicker wires once tightened. Replacing handlebars on my bike used to be something I would do anything to avoid. Even lubricating them wouldn't help much. As soon as I realized I could use an ice pick to distribute the lubricant evenly, they came right off. Sealant clogged the valve in this case. If your bike chain keeps falling off, keep a pick handy to fix it without getting off your bike. You can buy ice picks and I'll link them below, but I prefer to make custom ones. I brazed this one with a nail on one side and an Allen key on the other to avoid bending and heat treating steel. I made this interesting texture using a carbide burr on my flex shaft rotary tool. This pick has a magnet on one side and a hook I cut from a long suspension spring I salvaged from a washing machine. Spring steel is the best for making ice picks because it's hardened and resists bending or breaking when abused. I made this one from a spring as well, following the same principle, and the other side from a dull needle file. This one used to be a screwdriver. I even made one from a stainless steel bike spoke for the toaster. You don't need much more than a drill, an angle grinder, and epoxy to make them. If you found this video interesting, check out my video on the best tips and tricks to optimize your Leatherman multi-tool. You might find it, along with my other videos, interesting as well.